You gotta get to heart.
We could come to order, please. This is a special called meeting of Alamance County Board of Commissioners on February 14th, 1 p.m. for the purpose of considering two contracts, one with U.S. Marshals Service and one with the U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement. Before we begin, first I would like to welcome and recognize Mr. Finley. Mike Finley is here with us from Senator Burr's office, and we are so glad and appreciative that you are here. We don't often get federal representatives here, and welcome. Now, Commissioner Sutton, if you would please lead us in the invocation and the pledge.
Yes, ma'am. It's an honor. Before I do that, I've already kind of told the sheriff, but after I get through, I'm going to ask him to give our Pledge of Allegiance, if you would, if you'd lead it. Having come back from our nation's capital in the presence of the greatest government in the world and greatest country in the world, our President of the United States, your meeting there was absolutely unbelievable, and I think it'd be apropos for you to give our pledge, if you would. If we could take a moment, please. My Heavenly Father, thank you for another revelation of your great power with such a beautiful day being given to us. Help us to realize that we that want to believe and participate, that what is said in the Bible in Chronicles, or Corinthians, forgive me, I get those two confused, that if we will ask for forgiveness in our country, that our country will be healed. Please be with the leaders of this country, the leaders of the world, to make mankind do what it needs to do to have this planet be as it ought to be. Take care of our commissioners, our county workers, our county management, other people outside of this arena, those that need help, small or large, help us all to pray for those that need it. Amen.
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 Please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, Sheriff.
Yes, ma'am.
The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Madam Chairman and Commissioners. I'm appearing for you today to ask for y'all's approval of two contracts, one with the United States Marshal Service and one with Immigration Customs Enforcement. The first I'm going to talk to you about is the Marshal's contract. For several years, we've had a contract with the United States Marshals and have been holding U.S. Marshal inmates and detainees. We decided to renegotiate a contract with them because certainly the years have gone by and the expenses have gone up. We initially, with the Marshals, had a contract for $66.38. We have a new contract that is before you today for $82 per day, per bed. And the minimum beds that we would supply to them is 44. 40 male, 4 female beds. However, the last couple months we've been holding over 100 U.S. Marshal prisoners here at the Alamance County Jail. A lot of that was because of the shutdown. The Marshal didn't have the people to transport these individuals. So that will probably go down 20 or 30, but we will hold probably more than 44. We try to help them where we can if we have the bed space. By doing that, the 44 beds times $82 a day, if that's what we were stuck at, times 365 days a year, should bring in $1,316,920 to the county. The Marshal Service has also agreed to provide us payment for eight more officers to do transportation at $29 an hour to transport their inmates or detainees to courts in Winston, Greensboro, wherever, or if they have to go to the hospital. Any questions from that? Like I say, we, this is sort of a continuation because we've always had a contract with the United States Marshal Service. I don't know, do y'all want to vote on each contract or let me do both of them?
Yeah, we'll vote on each contract separately.
Okay. Do you have any questions whatsoever about the U.S. Marshal contract?
I'd like to ask a question of Susan. I think we've gone over this at our last meeting, and we've talked about it on the phone, and I still haven't seen any numbers. I want to know how we depreciated the use of our jail per capita or whatever in this contract.
So how that depreciation figure came about was they took our cost allocation plan that we have that is performed by an outside agency and used those figures for those plans.
Okay, I haven't seen those figures is what I'm saying.
I can provide you a copy of it.
Okay, I thought I... Well, I did ask about that earlier. Yeah. I don't mean to be rough on that. I just want to make sure that, you know, they're using our building, and I know you can depreciate it, which is financially advisable for us to do, and I just want to see those numbers.
Yes, I'll be glad.
All right, thank you.
You need a motion?
We do.
We need a motion. Oh, so moved.
Second.
So we have a motion and a second to approve this U.S. Marshal Service contract with Alamance County. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? Okay, Sheriff, what about the Immigration and Customs Enforcement contract?
Okay, certainly we've had a IGSA contract with them even before we approached them with redoing and starting to hold ICE inmates or detainees again. We had a contract that they had not pulled from us. However, once again, the contract for that was $66, I think, and 95 cents per day per bed. And so we renegotiated, and it's been a, and I want to thank Brian and the finance department. It's been back and forth, back and forth. And the contract before you today consists of, they want us to, they pay us where we fill the beds or not, 30 beds for the first 30 days at $135 a day. Then after 30 days, the remaining 11 months, this is a one-year contract, there will be 50 beds where they fill them or not at $135 a day. With that, the 50 beds times 335 days times $135, the way I got it figured, you'll be bringing in $2,261,250 for the remaining 11 months and $121,500 for the 30 days, 30 beds. And that was in effect beginning February 1. Y'all are signing contract today, but they agreed to that in the contract to begin February 1. These inmates that will be held, detainees, will be held at the Alamance County Jail until they transport them wherever they're going to be transported to, and that's none of my business, you know, where they're going. My job is to make sure we follow all of the national standards that we have to follow to maintain that contract. Immigration and Customs Enforcement has in the contract is included in $135 is two vans, 22 new personnel to make sure everything, transport, et cetera, equipment, building to store our chemicals in, because we've been having to store them at the detention center, and they says you can't have chemicals, cleaning chemical scores got to be outside. So they have worked with us to come up with an amount of money that will cover that for the year and the salaries of the officers.
You know, years ago, if you remember when we had the bus from INS, the big one,
yes,
up here. And it was my understanding there was a controversy or maybe, yeah, or non-agreement about breakfast cost. As far as best of my memory, I heard that figure come up. And have we got three meals a day figured in all this? Or
every bit of it's figured in, sir. Mm-hmm.
Three meals?
Yes, sir. Three meals, cost of supplying underwear, uniforms for the inmates, you name it, is figured into the contract.
What was the deal with the breakfast deal? Do you remember that?
I remember it.
It wasn't in the contract or something. We didn't want to like get free breakfast.
Well,
we didn't
want to do it. What that was all about, Mr. Sutton, was they would come in the morning, mm-hmm, and pick these individuals up, And they want, it was actually a breakfast or bag lunch for them to take with them because they were on the bus going, I think, to Atlanta, and they couldn't stop and feed them. And that was, I think that's what you're talking about.
I remember that.
Yeah.
So you had to provide the bag
lunch. Yes, sir. We packed lunch for each and every one of them. And initially, that was not in the contract.
Right.
But we wasn't going to let them starve going down to Atlanta. Any questions? And I know I covered it rather hurriedly.
What other questions do you all have?
Please, if you have any, ask.
I don't have any.
I have a couple, if nobody else does. One, I wanted just to verify with our attorney that this doesn't conflict with any settlement agreement with the Department of Justice that was reached a few years ago. This is no problems with
we
that.
Have had this contract since, I think, 2008. It was not terminated as part of the 287G termination.
So there's no issue?
There shouldn't be, as long as we comply with the terms of our settlement contract.
Right. Okay, and then, Sheriff, I just wanted to, people have expressed concern that it might open up the county to a lawsuit. Can you address that? If somebody were concerned that, you know, we might get in, somebody could sue us for holding ICE detainees. How would you respond to that?
I'll respond to that you know, anybody can sue you. Anybody can sue you.
We know that.
I mean, believe me, I experienced that.
We're all aware of that.
We, of course, federal judge ruled in our favor, but like I say, anybody can sue you. But I want the commissioners to understand and the people of Alamance County to understand that we've got to look after the safety of our citizens here. And like I've told y'all before, I took an oath to protect our citizens from all foreign and domestic criminals. And this is part of this. If you think that the Alamance County border, Guilford County, stops anybody from crossing, it don't. In Washington, D.C., this past week, 3,000 sheriffs signed a letter for the president's supporting his efforts because they're having to deal with the same things that we're dealing with here. I talked to a sheriff from Arizona. Every year, they find 100, no less than 100 skeletal remains in the fields of his county. They don't know who these people are. Some families over in Mexico think their kids are here in America when they could be laying out there. That's what I call immoral. And that's what we're trying to stop. There's a way to come here. I wish our nation would make a more faster way. But there's a legal way, and until that happens, I will enforce the laws of our land that I was sworn to do.
Sheriff, you know, one of the reasons that I support this contract is because it's expected to bring financial benefits to the county. Mr. Haygood, I was wondering if you could tell us anything about your plans to monitor the program to be sure that at the end of the 12 months of the contract that we have some kind of idea about what kind of financial position the county is in after doing this.
So we've worked with Susan and her staff in the finance department to set up codes in the sheriff's budget where he will be able to track revenue specifically coming in from Immigration and Customs Enforcement as well as U.S. Marshal. We've also set up program codes in his budget for expenditure tracking too. So we should be able to keep a pretty good idea of how the money is coming and going for both programs and be able to report that to the sheriff or the board as needed.
Also, the reason mainly we took a one-year contract, we will reevaluate it at the end of 1 year. If it is not good, we will cancel it. If it is, then we'll continue.
That's fair enough.
That's right.
I was getting ready to ask that question.
Yep. Alamance County's not looking to hand the federal government any charity.
No, ma'am. We are not. We've handed them enough. Now, our Marshall contract is for 36 months.
Okay. That's good to know. Yeah. Good to know that distinction. And somebody expressed to me that, in their opinion, there might be an incentive for the Sheriff's Department to round up people to detain under this contract. How would you respond to that?
The Alamance County Sheriff's Department is not rounding up anyone unless they do a murder, drug trafficking, and that's not rounding up. We treat the American citizens the same way. I hear you're taking these people away from their families. Well, if I arrest Eddie Boswell for murder, guess what? He's taken away from his family too. We're going to deal only with the people that violate the law in our jurisdiction. The people coming in here is going to be brought in here by ICE from other areas of this state.
Great. Mr. Sutton, I didn't know if you had a motion you wanted to make.
I didn't realize, I'm not a big motion person, but I definitely make a motion to do this.
That's what I thought you might want.
Okay, well, thank you.
I'll second that.
Okay, we have a motion and a second.
Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you. Well, I'm proud to do what I feel like I have to do as a commissioner, as a citizen of this country, and execute the laws of this nation.
Well, I thought you might be, so that's why I wanted to be sure you got that opportunity. So we have a motion and a second to approve this contract. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed? Thank you, Sheriff.
Thank you. I'd like to thank the commissioners for your support on this issue. And I'd like to thank our county manager and his staff and our legal staff for reviewing the contract. I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Sheriff. Mr. Haygood, you got a budget amendment for us?
I do. Good afternoon, commissioners. So at this time, I'd like to present a request that the Board of Commissioners approve a budget amendment to increase the Alamance County Detention Center budget by $1,255,732.20. These are the costs for the detention center operations from February 15th to June 30th, operating these new programs for the Marshal Service and Immigration. The new revenues that will cover these additional expenditures will be coming from additional revenue we'll realize from the U.S. Marshal Service. That dollar amount is $191,544.80. Our new revenues that we would realize from ICE would be $837,000. We would also need to budget Alamance County appropriated fund balance in the dollar amount of $227,187.40. The reason we have to use fund balance up front is because primarily for capital costs that the Sheriff's Department has to front in order to meet the Marshal Service and ICE requirements for this program. Those capital needs include several vans, the storage building that the Sheriff mentioned, a key cabinet. We have to front those monies from the county's fund balance, but we will recoup those monies throughout the contract period. So over the next year period, we will receive those funds back and put them back into fund balance. So if the board approves this budget amendment that's before you this afternoon, that will give the Sheriff's Department the ability and permission to begin hiring the 30 new positions that are proposed to accommodate these new programs, and also give them the ability to begin purchasing the equipment that they need. It also, the budget amendment also gives detention officers ranked sergeant and below a 3% salary increase as of March 1st, which is part of the retention plan that we've discussed. We do have another feature of our detention plan that we're waiting to implement. We talked last time about a separation allowance for detention officers that would bring them up to the same place where sworn officers are. We're researching that to see if we can legally, by statute, offer that benefit. If we determine that we can, I'll be coming back to you with a budget amendment that will budget more of this new revenue, and with our personnel manual that you'll have to vote to change to give that benefit to detention officers. But we hope to know that soon. So you're voting today for this budget amendment only to amend the budget from February 15th to June 30th. But in your packet, just for your knowledge, is a description of the one-year costs and revenues of the entire program. So as the Sheriff mentioned, the Marshal Service new per diem is $82. In order to make this program work, based on revenues versus expenditures, the Sheriff's Department will need to hold a minimum of 69 U.S. Marshal Service inmates. That is in line with what they have held on average for the last year. They have averaged 68 U.S. Marshal Service inmates in the jail. The new ICE per diem is $135. ICE is guaranteed a minimum of 30 detainees for the first month and 50 detainees for the next 11 months. That is whether we hold any detainees for these two groups or not. So the total one-year cost on the information in your packet is for all of this, for U.S. Marshals, ICE, and for the retention program, it's $2,847,491.09. And the total revenue that we are projecting is $2,847,491.09. So we are looking at program that is basically a wash for the county. And this budget amendment will put the funds in place to allow the Sheriff's Department to begin hiring and buying equipment immediately. So if there's any questions, I'll be happy to try to answer them. Appreciate Susan's help putting this financial piece together, too, so.
Just want to make a statement. In no way can we get this money and use it for anything else. We've had two different people come before this board and ask us to use this money for something other than for the sheriff's office and these, and the responsibilities that come with the contracts. But there's no way we can use any of this money for anything else, right?
Yes, these monies are, these revenues are covering the new cost. So if we were to try to use the revenue to spend somewhere else, what we've tried to avoid is committing county dollars to this that we're not going to get back. So this revenue is covering our cost for these programs. So it would be, it would not be appropriate for us to use these revenues elsewhere.
Right.
I'll make the motion to approve this amendment.
I'll second that.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Very quickly, before we call for the vote, I just wanted to take just a moment to thank our staff for all their hard work on these contracts, and also on putting together this special meeting. I know Tori Frank, our clerk, had a lot to do, and she was out sick Friday and came in Monday finding out we were going to have a special meeting on Thursday. So that was, I'm sure, an exciting moment for her day on Monday. She's done an outstanding job putting this together, and we appreciate that. Also, Susan, your work with, and our legal department with your work on vetting these contracts and making sure that they were up to snuff, and Mr. Haygood, all of your work as well. We appreciate that. So we have an emotion and a second to approve the budget amendment. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed? All right. Thank you very much. And the business of the board being concluded, we'll be adjourned.